In today's video, I'm going to be giving you 5 steps you can take to lower your HbA1c fast. And spoiler alert, these tips are super easy to implement. Hemoglobin A1c is a test used to measure your average blood sugar over the past 3 months. This test is used to diagnose and monitor diabetes. A healthy HbA1c level is between 4 to 5.6%. Above 5.7 indicates prediabetes, and above 6.5 indicates full-blown diabetes. Now, if your level is 5.7 or above, don't panic. It is entirely possible to bring that level down to within a healthy range. And that's what we're going to be talking about today. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Kait. I'm a certified health and nutrition coach. I post videos twice a week here on YouTube talking all things insulin resistance, weight loss, sleep, and more. So if you're ready to take control of your metabolic health, make sure to click that subscribe button. And you can also find me on TikTok and Instagram where I share new posts every single day. Lowering our fasting blood sugar is one of the best things we can do for our health. A high HbA1c score increases our risk of type 2 diabetes, heart disease, Alzheimer's, and other diseases. It also puts us at a greater risk of being overweight or obese. The reality is our blood sugar ties in with every aspect of our health. And the more we can control it and bring our A1c down, the better off we're gonna be. So let's get into 5 steps you can take to do just that. Number 1 is to intermittent fast. The quickest and most efficient way to lower your A1C is to incorporate some form of intermittent fasting into your routine. To intermittent fast means you have a daily fasting schedule. You split your time up each day into a period when you don't eat and when you do eat. One of the most popular variations is 16-8. You fast for 16 hours every day and you eat all of your food within an 8-hour window. So this can look like finishing your last meal at 6 p.m. in the evening and not eating again until 10 a.m. the next day. And the reason that fasting helps to bring your A1C down is that it improves insulin sensitivity. This means your cells taking glucose more readily, and this brings your average down. If you want to try intermittent fasting for the first time, I recommend starting only aiming for 12 hours a day. Stop eating at 8 p.m. in the evening, for example, and don't eat again until 8 a.m. and work your way up to 16 hours over time. Now, one tip that I can give you that will make intermittent fasting so much easier is to take an electrolyte supplement during your fasting window. Fasting can deplete your body's electrolytes, so it's important to get them in. But be careful about what brand you choose because a lot of them contain added sugar and other artificial ingredients, which can actually spike your blood sugar and work against your goal to bring your A1C down. I use Sodi's Everyday Hydration Salts because they don't break a fast. They have no added sugar or artificial sweeteners, and they're specifically formulated for intermittent fasting, so you can get enough electrolytes to meet your needs. If you want to check them out, you can head to hckait.com/Sodi and use code KATE15 to save 15% off your order. Step number 2 is to drink apple cider vinegar before bed. Drinking 1 tablespoon of apple cider vinegar diluted in water before bed has been shown to lower your fasting blood sugar the following day. You can also take it before meals to lower your blood sugar response to that meal. It has this effect because vinegar helps to slow down the rate at which your food is broken down, which means the spike in blood sugar is more gradual. Now, if you aren't a fan of the taste of apple cider vinegar, I do recommend the drinks from Good Idea as an alternative. Good Idea drinks contain a blend of amino acids that help to control blood sugar in a similar way to apple cider vinegar. These drinks are lightly carbonated and they taste a whole lot better than vinegar does. I will also put the link to check them out in the description box. Step number 3 is to take a walk in the morning. Take a walk in the morning before you eat breakfast. Some people experience what is known as the dawn phenomenon, where the liver dumps glucose into the bloodstream just before waking, causing fasting numbers to be elevated. But by going for a morning walk, you allow your muscles to use some of that glucose. Even better is that when we're using our muscles, they can actually take in glucose without the need for insulin. With less insulin needed, this helps our cells to become more insulin sensitive, bringing our A1C down over time. And this doesn't have to be a long walk. Even a quick one around the block can make a difference. So don't worry about doing anything crazy. It doesn't have to be extreme. Step number 4 is to get good sleep. Poor sleep has a huge impact on blood sugar. A recent study found that men who slept less were 2.8 times more likely to develop diabetes. Not only does poor sleep cause our fasting numbers to be higher, but it impacts our blood sugar the whole next day and promotes glucose intolerance. The blood sugar response to food you eat is more significant after a night of poor sleep versus a night of good sleep. On top of that, your body is more insulin resistant following a night of poor sleep. And the cherry on top is that poor sleep also affects your hunger hormones. Ghrelin, the hormone responsible for hunger, is going to be higher, and leptin, the hormone that signals when you're full, is lower. So you're going to be hungrier the entire day, which only adds fuel to the fire. I won't get too into how to optimize sleep in today's video, but I do have a bunch of other videos on the topic on my channel, so I'll link one up above if you want to know more. And finally, step number 5 is to reduce stress. I know, this is easier said than done, but being stressed can actually raise our blood sugar and cause more fluctuations throughout the day. When you are stressed, hormones such as cortisol and glucagon are released, and these hormones cause our body to release more glucose into the bloodstream, which over time can increase our A1C. Now, of course, we're all gonna be stressed out at some point or another, but if you can mitigate it and reduce your stress whenever possible, that's going to make a big difference. I've recently started incorporating some breath work into my morning routine, really only 5 minutes, and that has made a huge difference. A few weeks ago, I was starting to get really stressed out. I was out and then I got in my car and I could just feel the stress building up. And I put into practice what I'd been practicing. I remembered one of the breathing techniques that I'd been working on. I did it for a couple of minutes and I could just feel my stress reducing. Like I said before, easier said than done, but any little changes you can make to reduce stress, they're gonna help. Anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know in the comment section down below what your A1C is. Have you been able to bring it down? And what have you done to achieve this? Let me know down below. I love chatting with you guys in the comment section. So even if you just want to come and say hi, comments really support my video. They show YouTube that you enjoyed it and they push it out to more people. So yeah, come and say hi down below. And anything I mentioned in this video, including those electrolytes from Sodi, will be linked in the description box. If you did enjoy this video, you might also enjoy my video on the best types of fasting. You can check it out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my coaching programs, including my 7-day insulin resistance masterclass and meal plan, you can find that here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.